Hey, good morning. Happy Monday, everybody. I just again get on here each week to give you my Monday market update for the Kitsap County area. And I hope everybody had a great weekend. It was a very, very busy weekend for us. Fall is definitely here and it is chilly out. I definitely did notice that there is a snow covering on the Olympic Mountains already. So fall is, I think, a little early. So hopefully everyone has gotten all their outside projects done before the weather hits. So again, this is where I come each week to give you guys the most accurate and up-to-date information on real estate here in Kitsap County. And I'm just going to go ahead again and give you the breakdown on the activity that we've seen in the last week throughout the selected cities in Kitsap County. So again, this is for detached single-family homes only. This does not include condos or vacant land or rentals. Okay, so just a little side note there for you. So let's go ahead and jump right in, you guys. So let's go ahead and start with Port Orchard, which is where I'm at here. And so in the last week, you guys, we had 18 listings that sold, which is actually down from 23 the week prior. Pending, we had 7, which is up from 5 the week before. Active, we have 20 new listings for Port Orchard, which is up a little, just a little bit from 19 the week prior. Bremerton sold. We had 15 listings sold in the last week, which is down from 18 the week before. Pending, we had 8 in the last week, which is down from 9, so a little bit down from the week before. Active, we had 16 active new listings come on in Bremerton in the last 7 days, which is up from 13 the week before. Now let's talk about Silverdale. All right, always a hot area. So sold, you guys, in the last 7 days, we've had 6 listings that have sold, which is up from 3 the week before. Pending, we only had 2 go pending, which is down from 3 the week before. Now active, we had 7 new listings come on the market in Silverdale in the last 7 days, which is down from 8 from the week prior. So making the inventory even a little bit tighter than it already was in the Silverdale area at this time. Total listings for Silverdale is only at 40, which is down from 42 we were at the week before. So again, if you're looking to buy in the Silverdale area, I know you don't want to hear that, but that's kind of where we're at right now. Not a lot to pick from in Silverdale. And Paulsbo, looking a little bit better, but still not a lot to pick from. So let's talk about Paulsbo, because again, Silverdale and Paulsbo, Kingston, Suquamish, Indianola, those are all, very hot, desirable areas. So let's go ahead and talk about Paulsbo. So in the last 7 days, we had 9 listings come on in Paulsbo, which is down from 10. Pending, we had 6, which is up from 4 the week prior. Active, we had 7 new listings come on in Paulsbo, which is down from 10. So total active listings for Paulsbo is sitting at 62. We were actually at 72 the week prior. So again, even less inventory numbers available for Paulsbo. Now, the average days on market right now, you guys, is sitting at 39 days. So some houses, especially in the lower price ranges, move faster. Others move a little bit slower. But even then, you guys, it's considered a fast-paced market right now. Along with that, I want to kind of give you an idea and a breakdown on the different price range, what's available throughout the different price ranges here in Kitsap County to give you guys an idea of the inventory levels and kind of as a buyer, what you can kind of expect. As far as what you're going to have to pick from, okay, depending on whatever price range that you're pre-approved for. And again, pre-approval is something I'll talk about here in just a moment. So in the 200 to 250,000 price range, you guys, this is throughout all of Kitsap, there are 15 homes. Okay, so if you're in the 250,000 price range, there's not a lot to pick from. In the 250 to 300,000 price range, it starts to look a little bit better. There's 30 homes. And again, these are numbers for single-family detached homes. In the 300 to 350,000 price range, there are 40 homes. In the 350 to 400,000 price range, there are 54 homes. Okay, so as you can see, as the price ranges go up, you typically have a little bit more to pick from, and a typically a smaller pool of buyers as the prices go up. In the 400 to 500,000 price range, there's 125 homes available. So if you're in that price range, you got a lot to pick from. And again, this is for all of Kitsap. But as you can see, the amount of inventory is still really low. We're still in a very, very strong seller's market. I know I sound like a broken record, but I'm going to share with you guys. I've been reading, and the experts are predicting that inventory could be near record lows by early next year. Okay, so if you're thinking about buying and you want to have some inventory to pick from, now is a good time to buy. All right. Now, the very first step, and this is kind of talking about the pre-approval process, the very first step in the home buying process is to get pre-approved. You want to make sure that you're working with a good lender that can get the process started for you. I work with several great lenders. If you need one, just let me know, and I'd be happy to get you connected to who I work with. And you don't want to wait because, again, sellers, you know, especially in the lower price range of sellers, are still getting multiple offers on many of the listings on the market. So you want to work with a good agent to make sure that your offer stands out, you know, in front of the competition. All right. Now, if you're thinking about selling, again, now is a great time to get your home on the market, to get it sold quickly and for the most amount of money. And I'm going to leave links in the comments below here on this Facebook Live video for my home buyer guide and my home selling guide. I think that you'll find them very, you know, valuable and informative if you're looking to buy or sell. So those are free for you to download. I'll leave the link down below. And if you need an agent, I'd be happy to work with you. Reach out to me anytime with any questions you have, and I'd be happy to get those answered for you. And I hope this kind of gives you guys, again, you know, I try to come here every week to give you guys good insight on the Kitsap County market, you know, where we're at. And again, you know, we've been in a seller's market now for quite some time. So that's my money market update for this week. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I hope you guys make it a great home buying and selling day. And I will definitely see you guys next week.